Okay, hello everyone. In previous class we discussed linear search algorithm. In linear search algorithm, if you want to search any element, those elements are going to be searched sequentially, means looking each and every element from beginning of the array to end of the array. That is the linear search technique. Now in this class, now we are going to be discussing binary search algorithm. What do you mean by binary search algorithm? Binary search algorithm in which the given array is divided into two parts and finding a particular element in an array, if this process is continuously goes on until unless the element is going to be found out or located in that array. That's why it is called as a binary search. Binary means two, means given entire array is divided into two parts and finding a particular element, so that it is going to be reducing the half of time of searching element in the given array. That is called as a binary search technique. In linear search technique, if you want to search any element, we don't have any restrictions. You are allowed to store elements in a random wise. You are allowed to access, or you are allowed to get find that element in that array without applying or without having any conditions to store elements into that array. But in binary search, we are having certain restrictions. That is, whatever you want to search element in a linear search, whatever you want to search element using binary search technique, then array elements must be in a sorted order. Means these array elements must be in increasing order or decreasing order. Then only it is possible to find a particular element from the given array. If these array elements are in unsorted order, then it is not possible to apply binary search to unsorted array to search a particular element in that array. Its conditions, these important conditions you have to remember. That is, if you want to search any element using binary search technique, then the array elements must be in a sorted order. Sorted order means these array elements must be organized in increasing order or decreasing order, any one of the format. Then only it is possible to find a particular element in a given array. If they are unsorted, then it is not possible to find a particular element from this array by using binary search technique. It is an important note we have to note for by performing binary search operations. And this algorithm is important for 5 marks. Frequently, it is asked in your examinations to make this mark as an important question. Now we are going to see at a glance the steps involved in this binary search algorithm, and we are going to be discussing each and every notations which we are going to use in this algorithm. This algorithm once again consists of 4 steps. First one is step 1, set B equal to LB and E equal to UB. Phase B equal to LB means lower one, means if I am going to consider an array in which the 0th index or lowest index of that array is called as a lower one. That value I am going to be initializing for a variable B. And E equal to UB. U equal to UB means UB is upper one. Upper one means highest index of that array. If I am going to have an array, the highest index of that array is called as an UB. That value is going to be assigned for an E. Now we are initializing two values. Those are B and E. B means LB. LB means lower bound. It is the lowest index of that array. E means end of that array. That is equal to UB. UB means upper bound. That is highest index of that array. Step 2. While B is less than R equal to N, we have to repetitively execute this set of statement until unless beginning is n, beginning is less than or equal to n, then we have to continuously execute this set of statement. For that we require while b is less than or equal to n. Next one is m equal to integer of b plus e divided by 2. It is important step which is dividing the entire array into two parts. I told binary search means which is going to be dividing the entire array into two parts and start searching element in only the particular portion of that array. How it is implemented? It is implemented with the help of this step. Now I am going to be dividing whole array into two parts. Within that part, I am going to be searching a particular element. For that, we require n equal to integer
integer of b plus e divided by 2, which is dividing entire array into two parts. Next one is, if search element is equal to a of m, se means search element. The search element is a of m means I divided an array at middle of that array, whatever I am searching, which is exactly the element which is divided at that point. If it is there, then I'm going to be assigning SE is equal to A of M, then I'm going to be changing the location value to an M. Initially, location value will be a minus 1. In linear search, we discussed LOC equal to minus 1 because we don't know or we not yet know the position of an element in a given array. For that, we assign the location value as a minus 1. In the same way, in this binary sense also, we are going to be initializing LOC equal to minus 1 initially. Once I am going to be finding the position of a particular element, after that I am going to be changing the location value to a particular value, that is M. If I convert the element, then I am directly, search element is less than or A of M, then I am going to be changing end value equal to M minus 1. Else, I am going to be changing beginning equal to M plus 1. It means that, let us consider I divided this array into this part, I am going to be searching particular element. The particular element which does not exist in this first half portion of the element, then I need to change this beginning value from 0 to 3. These are implemented using these two different steps, that is E equal to M minus 1 means middle minus 1, else B equal to M plus 1. We are going to be discussing one pressing sample example for searching element in an array with help of binary search. Then we are going to know about how these end and beginnings are working. If location is greater than or equal to 0, means if we find out an element, that is a location, we change the value of location. If location value is greater than or equal to 0, then we are simply printing search is successful. Else, if we didn't find the element in a given search, then we are not making any changes to a location of a variable, it will be a minus 1. Then it will be printing else part of this algorithm, that is print search is unsuccessful. Before we discuss the terminologies which are going to be used in this algorithm, just I am going to be explaining, that is B equal to LB. LB is lower bound, that is the 0 index of that array. E is upper bound means highest index of an array, that is 4, that is n minus, it is beginning is 0, n is n minus 1. In this array I am having total 5 elements, 5 minus 1 is 4, that is n minus 1. SE means searching the element. The particular element which I am going to be locating in this array, that is called as an SE, searching element. LOC equal to location. Location means if I find out the particular element in a given array, I need to note down the position of that element in that array. That is called as an LOC. Means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, any one of these locations might be existing in this array to find that particular element, that is called as an LOC, location. Next one is M. M is a middle element. I told binary search which is going to be dividing the given array into two parts. Right? If I divide the array into two parts, the divided part is called as a middle part of that array, that is called as an M, middle element. Wherever exactly middle of that array I divided, that is called as a middle element. For we took a variable, yeah. Now we are going to trace out this algorithm with help of this example. I took an element, array of 5 size. I stored element 3, 5, 8, 15 and 20, 5 different elements, and all these elements are in sorted order. If they are sorted order, then only it is possible to apply a binary search of this array. If these array elements are unsorted order, then it is not possible to apply a binary search. My array elements are in sorted order. Now I am going to be applying binary search to search a particular element from this array.
In this b equal to 0, that is beginning, that is lower bound, lowest index of that array. E is upper bound, upper bound means highest index of that array, that is 4. Now I want to find element 15 from this array, means element is 15. Element means 15. Now I want to search element 15 from this array using this binary search technique. I initialize all those things, b equal to 0, e equal to 4, search element is 15, 5, beginning is less than or equal to n. What is b value? B value is 0, 0 is less than or equal to n is 4, 0 is less than or equal to 4, yes, condition become true. If this condition become true, then array is going to be dividing one array into two parts. If this condition is false, then it is not to divide given array into two parts. Now this condition becomes true. Now I am going to be dividing given array into two parts with help of this statement, that is m equal to integer of beginning is 0 plus n is 4, 0 plus 4, 0 plus 4 divided by 2, that is m equal to 2. M equal to 2 means exactly second position I am going to be dividing this array into two parts. Why we require this? Because it is going to be reducing the searching time of a given array exactly half of that searching time. For that we require dividing given array into two parts. Now I divided at the position 2 into two parts. Next, location equal to m. Now I am assigning, I divided at second position. If search element equal to a of m, search element is 15. 15 is equal to m is 2, if m is 2, a of m means a of 2, a of second position, I store an element a. 15 is equal to 8, 15 is not equal to 8, condition become false. If this condition become false, now I need to look out the element in the second part. Whichever I am searching element 15, 15 is greater than 8. 15 is greater than 8. Then I am going to search element in the first part of this array. Right? I need to look out the element in second part of that array. Then how do I need to search that element in this array? For that, we are having these two different steps. That is changing n value and changing beginning value. Because now I need to start searching from second part of that array. Then how I need to change beginning of that array? Beginning of that array. That is going to be done with help of these two different steps. This condition becomes false, then it will be continued execution for the next step. That is, if search element is less than a of m. What is search element? Search element is 15. 50 is less than a of m, we are stored element 8. 15 is less than it? No. Condition become false. If this condition become false, then it will be executing else part. In else part, what I am performing? I am performing b equal to m plus 1. Beginning. Now, because now I need to change beginning value. Why? Because whatever I am looking element, I divided array into two parts. In first part, the searching element does not exist. Because searching element is 15, 15 is greater than 8. So I need to change the beginning value. How it is done? That is done with help of these two steps. In beginning, now beginning, the condition becomes false. If this condition becomes false, it is go for an else part. Else part, b equal to m plus 1, beginning equal to m value is 2.
plus 1. Now beginning value is 3. Now beginning value is 3. Next, n will be as it is 4. Now I will be start with the second set of executions. Initially we started with the beginning value 0 and the n value 4. I divided again into exactly 2 parts, but I found out I didn't find the element 15 in first part of the array, so I need to start looking that element into a second part of the array. For that I need to change the beginning value. For that we now perform these two operations, that is b equal to m plus 1. Now I change the beginning value, that is b equal to m plus 1, m is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3. Now beginning value is 3. Now beginning value is 3. Once again, beginning is 3. 3 is less than or equal to 4. 3 is less than or equal to 4. Condition becomes true. Enter into a loop. Once again, I need to find out the middle element, that is m. M equal to beginning is 3 plus n is 4. 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 is 7. 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 divided by 2. 7 divided by 2 is 3.5. Right? Now we took an integer. Integer means which is discarding fractional part of that number and which is considering only integer part of that number. Now I am discarding 0.5. Now m is 3. M is 3. Now middle element is 3. Middle element is 3. Means now I divided array into exactly this position, means third position. Now my middle element is 3. Next, I find out the middle element. Now I need to compare my searching element and middle element of that array. My searching element and middle element of that array. My searching element is 15. My searching element is 15. A of m is 3. A of third position. A of third position. I stored element 15. 15 is equal to 15. Yes. 15 is equal to 15. Condition gets satisfied or condition becomes true. Then it is changing the location value. Then it will be changing the location value. LOC equal to M. M is 3. Now location value is 3. Now location value is 3. Go to step 3. Step 3, location value I overwritten with the m value. The recently which we find out the middle element value, that is 3, location value equal to 3 right now. Now go to step 3 is if location value is 3, 3 is greater than or equal to 0, condition become true. If this condition become true, then simply printing search is successful. It is how we are finding the particular element in a given array with help of this binary search. I think or I hope all of you got the example of this binary search technique with this tracing example. You need to